This is the Hibs Club, where 3 weeks ago I met Lee Martin, and he described to me how he wanted to make movie magic. Not all, though, was as it seemed.
You must have been delighted when you got the call to come in and direct Card School.
Oh yeah, it was a great thrill. It was nice to see they finally made the right decision to get rid of the first guy and bring me on board.
Really, we were told the first director was maimed by a badger.
That's crazy talk. How can a man train a badger to do something like that?
Nobody's mentioned training it.
Well, of course not. It's not possible. Who told you?
Mark, tell us about your experiences of shooting the up-and-coming film Card School.
That was an embarrassment from start to finish. In fact, I think I should be asking you to blur my face when you broadcast this interview.
What problems did you encounter on set?
Well, apart from dodgy lighting, crap sound, and a terrible script, nothing. The director, that was the problem though. He had the mental capacity of a goldfish. In fact, he wasn't even the initial choice to direct this film. The first choice was maimed in a bizarre incident with a badger.
Oh, it was a lovely experience, you know, as a seasoned thespian, you know. I've always found myself wanting to tread the boards. That's the theatre. And it's always nice to do something like this every so often, just to keep one's feet in the ground, you know.
And did you have any problems with the director?
Oh, the director, lovely fellow. Very delicate, pretty features, you know. He's a lovely man. Terrible personal hygiene, though. Oof.
How so?
Horrible. I just don't think he bathed.
Well, there was problems with the direction from the very start.
But you were the director, were you not?
Well, yeah, but there's only so much one man can do. I show the way, but they don't follow.
How was your relationship with the actors?
Oh, well, Stephen was a perfect gentleman. Almost bald, but he wasn't bitter about it. I liked that about him. It did cause problems on set, though. The camera kept reflecting off his head.
And Mark?
We just didn't see eye to eye from the very start. He was very aggressive towards me. He called me names. He said I was smellier than a Frenchman. Sorry.
It's okay, take your time.
He was a bad man.
You too. With the...
Sorry.
Oh, for f***ing sake. Are you going to do this every time? This is the seventh time. Every f***ing time you're doing this. F***ing amateurs. Can we get somebody else to do this? This guy hasn't a clue. Good riddance. At all.
Where would you rate Lee Martin amongst the directing greats?
Now you're asking me where would I rate Lee Martin with the directing greats. There was a great uncle of mine called Sir Stanley Trout, and he was quite possibly one of the worst directors I've ever encountered in my life, but he was family, so I would put him up there with him. Almost as bad.
Okay, can I stop you there, please? Can I stop you there? Right, just one or two problems. Firstly, get that desk line I'm looking like out of my bloody way. It's in shot constantly. And get that strap out of the front of the camera. Come on!
He needs to put the strap on.
I've just had just about enough of your lip.
Talking to me?
I don't want that anymore.
Talking to me?
And you are supposedly classically trained actor. Is there any chance you could emote for the camera a little bit?
Emote?
It's like watching a Charlie Sheen film.
Oh dear God, be magnanimous.
Watching a Charlie Brown film?
I've never been so insulted in all my life.
Well, you should have came here sooner then, shouldn't you?
Asshole.
That's it, I'm going back to my trip.
I'm surrounded by
never again.
F***ing assholes, whole crew.
Amateur, can't take the truth. Outrageous.
Which one
new
the
actor.
Worst?
That's it, we need new.
Yeah, I'll recast this. Yeah, actor, new director. That's what we need.
Sorry,
man.
Get
that camera out of my
face, son. Anyone who has seen me perform has realized it isn't just acting. It's a way of life. I was born to be an actor, and I will die an actor. A very old actor, I hope. Yeah. But acting is like an experience, you know. It's like taking a good shit, you know. It can blow your mind. I hope, am I allowed to say shit?
We'll blank it out.
Blank it out? So I'm being censored now. Oh boy, you're being cautious, aren't you? You're a cautious fellow.
Your previous titles have all been pornographic films. How have you found the step up to drama?
Never ask me about my past. Next question.
We asked Lee's biggest fan how sad he would be to see Lee leave the porn industry.
What?
Are you ashamed of what you've done in the past?
Well, no, why would it be, you know? Who would do any different, you know? Great view, great money. Why wouldn't I do it? Why would I be ashamed?
So you're not ashamed?
No. I've told you before, stop asking me about it.
If you're not ashamed of your past, then why are you so touchy about it?
To discover what people actually knew about Lee Martin's past, we spoke to some guy. Excuse me, sir.
What?
You look like the kind of fellow who likes pornographic films. Are you familiar with the work of Lee Martin?
No.
Have you seen Schindler's Fist?
No.
What about Forrest Humps?
No.
The Da Vinci Load?
No.
Are you lying?
Yes.
Would you work with Lee Martin again?
Are you kidding me? This is the man that thinks a cartoon Boeing is hilarious. I'd rather lick the sweat of a horse's arse crack.
Would you ever work with Lee Martin again?
Yeah. Now that is a question. Yes, it was. Yes, I suppose, and if a totally different project, and perhaps if he was a totally different person, and I was, you know, perhaps a less of an actor, then probably still no. I don't think I would. That Mark fellow, oh dear God, I don't know where I got him from. Personally, I'd rather parade around in women's underwear and, you know, nice bra, pointy heels.
I've spoken to numerous crew, not just Lee, who all claim you have an anger management problem. How do you respond to that?
It's rubbish!
Lovely silk stockings. I'm sorry, what was the question again?
Would you consider working with Mark and Stephen again?
Well, I would certainly consider working with Stephen again. He was a very professional guy. I liked him. But Mark, no. My mom told me to stay away from bullies.
I think it's great to be known for something. And I'm sure when I'm gone, that's what I'll be remembered by. And as Oscar Wilde said, it's better than people talking about you than not talking about you. I don't think that's an exact quote, but I think you get the gist.
He was gay as well.
He was what?
Homosexual.
Oscar Wilde was? Oh, I didn't know that.
Over the years, your name has time and again been linked with organized crime and even Would you like to take this opportunity to tell us your side of the story?
I'll tell you a story. You cut that question or I'll cut you.
Oh, I don't think I'll be in any more of his plays, though.
And what's next for Lee Martin?
Well, there's plenty of jobs on the table for me. McDonald's, Burger King. I've got plenty of offers.
You're going into advertising then?
Yeah. Advertising.
I heard you on the wireless back in 52. Lying awake intently tuning in on you. If I was young, it didn't stop you coming through.
Would explain an awful lot.